He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Today we're going to practice naming ionic compounds. So first, given the name, we want to provide the molecular formula. So we have aluminum oxide, potassium sulfate, and iron 3 sulfide. Then, given the molecular formula, we want to provide the name. So we have Mg3N2, Mn3PO42, and FeCl2. So if you're not sure how to approach this, go ahead and check out my tutorial on naming ionic compounds. That'll tell you everything you need to know. And when you're ready, give these a try. So let's take these first three where we're given the name. Now let's try aluminum oxide. So we know these are ionic compounds. So what we have to do is figure out exactly what ions these are. So if we have an aluminum ion, what is going to be the charge on that ion? What is the common charge for aluminum? Well, that is going to be Al3+. And we can tell because of where it is on the periodic table. We know that if it loses 3 electrons, it will gain noble gas electron configuration. So that will be the common ion for aluminum, and thus in aluminum oxide, we know we have Al3+. Then for oxide, we know that that is going to be O2-. The suffix "-ide," whenever we see oxide or fluoride or chloride, we know that that is an anion with noble gas electron configuration. So oxygen has to gain 2 electrons to attain neon electron configuration, so that is the oxide ion. So we have Al3+ and O2-. And if these are going to come together to form aluminum oxide, which is a neutral compound, what ratio must these come together in order to form a neutral compound? Well, we know we're going to need 2 aluminum ions for every 3 oxide ions, because that is going to add up to 6 positive charges and 6 negative charges, right? 2 times 3+ is 6+. And 3 times 2- is 6-. That is how we're going to balance the charges on these ions. So that is the ratio of these ions in this compound. And so we can just write that out as a molecular formula, Al2O3. Now let's move on to potassium sulfate. So potassium, what is a potassium ion? Well, that is going to be K+. Because if potassium loses 1 electron, it will attain noble gas electron configuration. So that is the common charge for potassium. Now, how about sulfate? Sulfate is a polyatomic ion. It is SO4 2-, and that's just something we kind of have to know. We're gonna have to memorize some of these polyatomic ions. So sulfate is SO4 with a 2- charge. So once again, what is the ratio in which these must come together in order to generate a neutral compound? Well, we have a 1+ charge and we have a 2- charge. So we're going to need 2 potassium ions for every sulfate ion so that we have 2+ and 2-, and that will generate a neutral charge overall. So we put those together and we get K2SO4, that is potassium sulfate. Now, moving on to iron 3 sulfide. Well, iron 3, without the 3, we wouldn't be too sure, because iron, as a transition metal, is capable of multiple oxidation states. But here, that's what the Roman numeral is for. 3 means 3+. So when we see iron 3, we know that we have Fe3+ ions. And then sulfide, just like oxide, is S2-. Sulfur needs to gain 2 electrons to attain noble gas electron configuration. So that is the sulfide ion. Now, once again, what is the ratio in which these ions must come together in order to generate a neutral compound? Well, we have 3+ and we have 2-. So what we have to do is have 2 iron ions and 3 sulfide ions. That will give us 6+ and 6-. That is neutral overall. So we have 2 irons and 3 sulfides, and we can write that out as Fe2S3. So these are the molecular formulas that correspond to these names. Now let's look at these molecular formulas and write the names. So we have Mg3N2. So Mg3, those are three magnesium ions. Those are Mg2 plus ions. And we just refer to the cation by the name of the element, so that is just going to be magnesium. And then the anion, therefore, must be the nitride ion. We have N3 minus. That's when nitrogen gains three electrons to attain neon electron configuration. And so we have three Mg2 pluses and two N3 minuses, and that gives us magnesium nitride. Now, moving on, we have manganese. We have three manganese ions, and in this case, these are going to be Mn2 plus, and we just refer to them as manganese. And then we have two phosphate ions. Those are PO4 3 minus. And so we have three manganese ions, we have two phosphate ions, those come together to form manganese phosphate. And lastly, FeCl2, we are not sure immediately what kind of iron ion this is, but let's look at the anion first. We have two chloride ions, those are Cl minus anions. Those each have a minus one charge, so that totals to a minus two charge overall in that formula unit. So in order to balance out the minus two charge to generate a neutral compound, we are going to need to have iron 2+, or iron in oxidation state 2. That means this must be iron 2 chloride, as opposed to iron 3 chloride, which would have to be FeCl3. So we have iron 2 chloride, and a nickname is ferrous chloride. We can also call this ferrous chloride, whereas if iron was in oxidation state 3, that would be ferric. But it's in 2, so this is iron 2 chloride or ferrous chloride. And these are the names associated with these molecular formulas.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.